The term mutation brings countless fantasies to our mind. Right from the ability to fly high in the sky to that of diving deep into the oceans. We all love to have such fantastic abilities. But these are all fictitious. Such fantasies don't exist. So can we say that mutation also doesn't exist? Hold on, that's not true. Mutation does exist. But mutation doesn't lead to such drastic changes in us humans. We can't have mutations that give us extraordinary powers. Rather, most mutations give rise to concern. They result in undesirable changes from time to time. In these upcoming videos, we shall majorly talk about mutation, what causes them, and their types in general. Let's begin with the definition first. Mutation, in simple words, is defined as sudden and abrupt changes to the genetic material of organisms. Now let's break this down to understand it better. Sudden and abrupt changes means a few changes that occur suddenly and are mostly unexpected. These changes are usually random and disruptive to the normal functioning of the cell. And where do these changes occur? They occur in the genetic material of the organism. That means in the DNA. And as a result, either the gene or the complete chromosome gets affected. So mutations are spontaneous changes that affect the DNA or the genes or sometimes the complete chromosomes. Now, since these are the areas that get altered, mutations are categorized on the basis of them. The two major types of mutation are genetic mutation and chromosomal mutation. Let us see these types. Let's consider this small section of the DNA. Let's say that this part changes into another. Another possibility is that either this base gets deleted or an extra gets inserted. In either case, the outcome is that the sequence of the gene will change. Technically, the reading frame will change. The ribosome assembly, including the tRNA, reads the genetic code in triplets. These triplets are called codons. Now, if there's any change in a single nucleotide, then the entire codon will change. Thus, the reading frame will change. And what will this result to? That's right, the altered gene will give rise to a different protein than the usual one. And there are chances that this defective protein turns out to be a harmful one. So any change in the DNA or in the genes can cause a shift in the reading frame. As a result, an altered protein is produced. This was the first type. Now let's zoom out of the DNA structure. What do we see? Yes, we see a typical chromosomal structure. Now tell me, what will happen if there are any alterations in its structure? And what if the total number of chromosomes get altered? Let's find the answer in the next part. This is a representative karyotype of a human. By now we know what a karyotype is. Can you try to give me some conclusions of it? You may say that it looks perfectly normal. But let me spot a flaw for you. Do you notice this set? This is the 21st chromosome set. Instead of having a normal pair of chromosomes, here we find a triplet. Now you may say that it may be good for the individual as it has an extra chromosome. But that's not the case. Any change in the number of chromosomes creates a lot of defects in the normal functioning of the body. On this note, let's understand chromosomal mutations. As the name says, chromosomal mutation means the mutation of chromosomes. And how exactly does it get mutated? It can happen in two ways. One way is where the structure of the chromosomes gets disrupted. The other is where the number of chromosomes are different than the usual in the organism. Let's have a look at each type. This is the structure of a typical chromosome. Now imagine this small part gets physically removed. This would result the chromosome in getting smaller as its segment is lost. This also means that if the segment had some important genes, then they will also get lost, which can result in severe abnormalities. Such type of a mutation is called deletion. This is where the part of the chromosome gets deleted. Now imagine this part of the chromosome gets duplicated. As a result, the chromosome's length increases. Needless to say, this will also result in some or the other abnormality in the individual. This type of mutation is called duplication. Now comes the next type. These are two different gene segments. Imagine they get flipped. Thus, the chromosome will appear like this. This is called inversion. Do you think this type of mutation is harmful? It may or may not be harmful depending on which genes get flipped. Now let's take one more chromosome. Imagine a part of this chromosome gets removed and gets inserted in this chromosome. What will be the result? That's correct. Both the chromosomes will change drastically. This type of mutation is called as insertion. And now comes the last type. Instead of a segment getting inserted to another chromosome, let's imagine a situation where a segment from each chromosome gets inter-exchanged. So this segment will get into this chromosome and vice versa. This kind of mutation also results in abnormalities as both the chromosomes get altered completely. Any idea what this type will be named as? Well, this type of mutation is called translocation. All these mutations resulting in the disruption of normal chromosomal structures are broadly kept under a single heading. They are categorized as chromosomal aberrations. Now, this was about the mutations that involve changes in the structure of the chromosomes. What about the mutations that involve a change in the number of chromosomes? Let's understand that in the next part. This is a normal chromosome, while this is a disrupted one. When the structure of a chromosome gets altered, it's called chromosomal aberration. We have seen this. Now let's move on to the second type. It's the mutation that involves a change in the number of chromosomes. It's called as aneuploidy. In literal terms, aneuploidy means the presence of an abnormal number of chromosomes in a cell. So the karyotype of a person with trisomy 21 is an example of aneuploidy. The presence of one additional chromosome in the 21st set gives rise to a total of 47 chromosomes in a person. So instead of a normal 46 chromosomes, this person has an additional chromosome. To be precise, an additional autosome. This case of aneuploidy is called trisomy 21. This is because there are three chromosomes instead of two in the 21st set. The problem of trisomy 21 leads to a condition called Down syndrome. We will get into the details of these disorders in our higher grades. But for now, let's focus on understanding the chromosomal mutations. This aneuploidy involved an autosome. Now tell me, what if the number of sex chromosome alters? So instead of XY, what if an individual has XXY? Is that even possible in the first place? Well, yes. There can be individuals with an additional X chromosome. This condition is called Klinefelter syndrome. Such individuals exhibit both masculine as well as feminine characteristics. Now, in the case of females, imagine that instead of addition, there is a deletion of an X chromosome. This would mean XO. So this individual will have only one X chromosome. This condition is called Turner syndrome. There are a few developmental abnormalities in such scenarios. These individuals have a total of 45 chromosomes only. These were a few examples of aneuploidy that involve autosomes and sex chromosomes. Now, before we conclude, tell me one thing. What causes these mutations? How can DNA or genes or entire chromosomes get altered? There are several factors named mutagens which lead to alterations. Some of them include radiation, chemicals, and even certain consumable items. To summarize, we have two major types of mutations. One which involves alterations in the DNA or the genes. These mutations result a shift in the reading frame, resulting in defective protein synthesis. Alterations in the structure results in chromosomal aberrations. They can be categorized as deletion, duplication, inversion, insertion, and translocation. The other is where the number of chromosomes are different than the usual in the organism. It's called aneuploidy. The changes can be in the autosomes as well as the sex chromosomes. Here, the total number of chromosomes in a cell are different from the usual. This was about mutations in general. To find more interesting videos, do not forget to subscribe to our channel.